Good evening. I'd like to welcome all of you to this, our celebration of worship, as we gather as a Jamaica Deanery for our Lenten services. Welcome to St. Peter's Church as we gather tonight for our celebration. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. God, before us, O Father, grace, most fervent, felicity, your continued help, that our works having begun, continue to end it in you, may glorify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our introit hymn, number 517, How Lovely is Thy Dwelling Place. Kindly stand. Bless the Lord who forgiveth all our sins.
His mercy endures forever.
Let us kneel as we recite the Decalogue. God spake these words and said, I am the Lord thy God who brought thee to the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. Thou shalt have none other gods but me. Lord, have mercy upon us. And incline our hearts to keep this law. Thou shalt not make to thyself any graven image, nor the likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or in the earth beneath, or in the water under the earth. Thou shalt not bow down to them, or worship them. Lord, have mercy upon us. Incline our hearts to keep this law. Thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy God in vain. Remember that thou keep holy the Sabbath day.
Lord, have mercy upon us, and incline our hearts to keep this law.
Honor thy father and thy mother.
Lord, have mercy upon us, and incline our hearts to keep this law.
Thou shalt do no murder.
Lord, have mercy upon us, and incline our hearts to keep this law.
Thou shalt not commit adultery.
Lord, have mercy upon us. And our hearts to keep this law.
Thou shalt not steal.
Lord, have mercy upon us, and incline our hearts to keep this law.
Thou shalt not bear false witness against thy neighbor.
Lord, have mercy upon us, and incline our hearts to keep this law.
Thou shalt not covet.
Lord,
Write all these thy laws in our hearts, we beseech thee. Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ saith. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and prophets. Let us humbly confess our sins unto Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from thy ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against thy holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought not to have done. And we have done those things which we ought not to have done. But thou, O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare thou those who confess their faults. Restore for those who are penitent, according to thy promises declared unto mankind in Christ Jesus, O Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may hereafter live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Your mighty and merciful Lord, grant you absolution and remission of your sins, true repentance, amendment of life, and the grace and consolation of his Holy Spirit. Amen. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal one.
Have mercy upon us.
Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal one.
Have mercy upon us.
Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal one. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, the source and perfection of all virtues, who didst inspire thy servant James DeKoven to do what is right and to preach what is true, grant that all ministers and stewards of thy mysteries may afford to thy faithful people, by word and example, the knowledge of thy grace through Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Kindly be seated for the readings.
A reading from Paul's second letter to Timothy, 2 Timothy chapter 2, verses 10 to 15. Therefore, I endure everything for the sake of the elect, so that they may also obtain the salvation that is in Christ Jesus with eternal glory. The saying is sure, if we have died with him, we will also live with him. If we endure, we will also reign with him. If we deny him, he will also deny us. If we are faithless, he remains faithful, for he cannot deny himself. Remind them of this and warn them before God that they are to avoid wrangling over words, which does no good, but only ruins those who are listening. Do your best to present yourself to God as one approved by him, a worker who has no need to be ashamed, rightly explaining the word of truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Hosanna, Hosanna, give joys, give thanks and and with thy spirit.
The Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory be to thee, O Christ.
Another parable Jesus put before the crowd. The kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed that someone took and sowed in his field. It is the smallest of all the seeds, but when it has grown, it is the greatest of shrubs and becomes a tree, so that the birds of the air come and make nests in the branches. He told them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a yeast that a woman took and mixed in with 3 measures of flour until all of it was kneaded.
Praise to thee, O Christ.
Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I say,
rejoice.
That's right. It's good when that's a full church and you hear that, isn't it? We need a little more of that. So a few years ago, I was on pilgrimage. I took a few people from St. Alban the Martyr. There was a few people from a church that I worked at in Westchester. Father Kevin, my spouse, he brought some people from his church, and he did a pilgrimage of Celtic Christianity, so Scotland and Northern England, and we went to some of the holy spots. I don't think that anybody who is the few who went are here, but something very interesting happened on that trip. Father Kevin and I had decided that we were going to worship on Sunday morning at the cathedral in Edinburgh, Scotland. Lovely cathedral. Afterwards, they have a lovely coffee hour. Well, tea for them. No coffee. I felt like I was at home. And the clergy of the cathedral, we were dressed appropriately, so they recognized us as clergy. They came over and started to talk to us. And with a little whisper, now I can't tell you which parable we read that morning, but I do remember it had something to do with a miracle. Jesus was talking about some miracle. Jesus had performed some miracle in the gospel that day, as Jesus often does. And the clergy huddled together afterwards and were giggling and said to us, "Isn't it funny that people believe that that actually happened?" Now, considering we are on the younger side, and among other things, there is usually a presumption, that Father Kevin and I are a certain kind of Christian, that we veer towards, let's say, the left of Christianity. Well, if you know the two of us, you know there's no bigger stick-in-the-mud traditionalist than the two of us. And so we turned, and we looked right at the priest who was saying, "Ha ha, these people who believe that this actually happened." Now, Father Kevin is like Father Foster, right? He doesn't say much, but you can tell everything by a look. Am I wrong, St. Peter's?
No.
No? Now, but we all know me, right? We know me by now, and this mouth doesn't stop. And I said, "What do you mean it didn't happen?" She said, "You don't believe this, do you?" I said, "Absolutely I believe that this happened. If I didn't believe this happened, I'd get a job that I made a lot more money and had a lot less headaches. Of course I believe that this happened." And she looked at me and said, "You believe in a silly god of magic." I said, "I believe in a god of miracles." Amen?
Amen.
The problem that we have in this world today is that we have become blind to God's miracles. We have taken them for granted, so we no longer pay attention to them when they happen right in front of our face. There is miracles going on in this room as we speak. And yet we have become so hard-hearted, we go to God and say, "Why aren't you performing miracles anymore?" But God performs miracles all the time. And that, I think, is what Jesus is trying to point out in the gospel lesson today. Think about this. God has created a seed that is almost microscopic. I know I do not like to garden because I don't like to go outside and get dirty, but I know some of you like to garden, right?
Yes.
Yep. And you know that those little seeds miraculously become these beautiful plants, right? Well, how many bakers? Do we have bakers here, people who bake? Or you all just go to the store and buy your bread now? Yeah, that's, Well, in days when people made bread, you could watch the yeast working. What a miracle. You have these little things, this little grainy thing. It's not grain, I know, it's alive, right? But then with a little water and you mix it with flour, and it grows. Well, those are two miracles of God that happen every day right in front of us. And yet we are too blind to see it. The church, I am afraid, has become a place where we no longer go out to proclaim the miracles of God, but instead we go and remind the world what problems they're already facing. Well, who needs that? That's my child, by the way. Sorry about him. We give thanks for the voices of children in our churches, because a church without the voices of children is a church that is dying. That is right. So we give thanks for the voices of children. That's in itself a miracle, is it not? The world does not need to hear from us its problems. Do you know what the world needs to hear from us? that God is performing miracles and we are full of the joy of God. Amen?
Amen.
Our theme this Lent has been rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I say rejoice. Because quite frankly, we have been in a bad mood for the last 3 years and I'm sick of it. I am sick of it. We are all sitting here today, right? God didn't have to make that happen, but we did. But he did. We are here, and we are rejoicing in the Lord because God deserves our joy. But I know you're sitting there, Father, we don't have much to rejoice about because that crazy man's going to get indicted. And then all the crazy people who follow him, right? All the crazy, are they're going to go crazy too. Well, you know what? That is not our problem. We can't control that, but we can control what we put out in the world. And if Christians are not going out and proclaiming joy, who is? Not the news media, not what you find on the internet. God doesn't want us to go out and be miserable. There is nothing worse than a church full of miserable Christians, and I've seen a few in my life. But we should take joy that God can take yeast and make it into bread. We should be joyful that God can take a seed and make it into a plant. We should be joyful that God can take bread and wine and turn it into the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We should be joyful that God loved us enough to send his son to be crucified for us and to raise him again on the third day. If there is nothing else in this world to be joyful for, then we better be joyful for that. So stop. All of us, myself included, this is not a me and us, because I've been miserable the last 3 years too. Stop worrying about it. Stop worrying about it. Because this is not our home. Our home is in the kingdom to come, where there is joy forevermore. God does not call us to be miserable Christians. God calls us to be joyful. We are set apart in our baptisms to spread the joy of Christ. What visitor wants to come in the doors of any of our churches in the Jamaica Deanery and see a bunch of miserable Christians? Fighting? Priest mad at them, them mad at the priest. Don't worry, I won't repeat that last week, but it'll be, you know. Fighting with each other, worried about what's going to happen tomorrow instead of taking great joy in the fact that the Holy Spirit has filled this place and given us the power and the direction and the energy to proclaim the gospel to the world. We live in a time where everyone needs an explanation for everything, where we are blind to the miracles of God, but we must go out and proclaim that God is proclaiming miracles this very second. And if you can't see them, and we're all blind to them, this is the season to open our eyes. Lent is a season to clear out the brush that gets between us and seeing the works of God in front of our face so that we can see the greatest miracle of all on Easter morning. We get too busy in Lent. We're too busy going to this thing and that thing. We're too busy getting ready for Easter. We're too busy, too busy, too busy. We're too busy and we ignore the call to wander with Jesus in the desert so that we may see God more clearly. Lent should not be about busyness, my brothers and sisters. Lent needs to be about learning how to rejoice in the Lord more fully. So we get on our knees and pray, and we open our Bibles and read, and we go to worship, and we ask God to sustain us and to fulfill us and to send us out to do the work that he has given us to do. If you have not experienced a miracle of God today, brothers and sisters, I invite you to clear out the brush in front of your eyes and see what God has done today. And don't keep that to yourself. Don't worry that somebody is going to say, you are insane that you think miracles happen in 2023. Who cares? Who cares if people think we're crazy? They thought Jesus was crazy. Go out and proclaim the miracles of God. Go out and proclaim that he has taken yeast and made it bread, that he has taken a mustard seed and made it a great bush. Go out and proclaim the joy of the Lord. Go out and rejoice in the Lord always. Again I say, rejoice. Amen.
Let us now stand and affirm our faith using the words of the Nicene Creed on page 7 of our bulletin. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried. On the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified. I spake through the prophets, and I believe in one holy Catholic apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Continue with the prayers of the people. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church and the world.
Almighty and ever-living God, who in thy holy word has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, receive these our prayers which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant that all those who do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word. and live in unity and godly love. Lord of all creation,
teach us thy ways.
Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, especially Justin, the Archbishop of Canterbury and leader of the Anglican Communion, Michael, our presiding bishop and primate, Lawrence, our bishop diocesan, Geraldine, Daniel, and William, our bishops, our clergy, Denison, Keith, Cassinda, Ryan, Karen, Frederick, Joshua, Bernice, Ephraim, Bernard, Mastin, Charles, and Steve, that they may both, by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. Lord of all creation,
teach us thy ways.
And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. Lord of all creation,
teach us thy ways.
We beseech thee also so to rule the hearts of those who bear the authority of government in this and every land, especially Joseph our president, Kathy our governor, Eric our mayor, Donovan our borough president, and our elected representatives, that they may be led to wise decisions and right actions for the welfare and peace of the world. Lord of all creation,
teach us thy ways.
Open, O Lord, the eyes of all people to behold thy gracious hand in all thy works, that rejoicing in thy whole creation, they may honor thee with their substance and be faithful stewards of thy bounty. Lord of all creation,
teach us thy ways.
And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor those on our sick and shut-in list, those known and unknown, those whom we carry in the silence of our hearts, and all those who, in this transitory life, are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. Lord of all creation,
teach us thy ways.
And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to grant us grace so to follow the good examples of the Blessed Virgin Mary and of all thy saints, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Lord of all creation,
teach us thy ways. Grant these our prayers, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate. Amen. My sisters and my brothers, walk in his light. The peace of the Lord be always, always with you. walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God. The offertory hymn. All things come from thee, O Lord, and of thy own have given back to thee. Amen. Blessed, O Lord, is thy gifts, may they be used to you unto your service through Christ, O Lord. Amen. We offer this Mass in thanksgiving for the life, work, and witness of James DeKoven, and in thanksgiving for Jamaica Deanery, the parishes and the clergy which comprise this wonderful Deanery. I invite you now to offer up to Almighty God those who were with us 3 years ago, but they're no longer here. As they bask in the cloud of witnesses, we give God thanks. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful depart to the mercy of God. Rest in peace. I invite you to offer your intentions as we celebrate this holy sacrifice of the Mass. All that's on your heart this past day, all that you've been through, which gives us the opportunity to rejoice in the Lord always. All these prayers and praise we offer to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is meet and right, so
to you. It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty, that we should at all times and all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, almighty everlasting God, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who was never tempted as we are, yet did not sin, by whose grace we are able to triumph over every evil, and to live no longer unto ourselves, but unto him who died for us and rose again. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and singing. Glory be to thee, O Lord our God, for that thou didst create heaven and earth, and didst make us in thine own image, and of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to take our nature upon him, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption. He made thee a full and perfect sacrifice for the whole world, and did institute, and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death and sacrifice until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks to thee, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it, in remembrance of me." Wherefore, Lord and Heavenly Father, we thy people do celebrate and make with these thy holy gifts which now offer unto thee, the memorial of thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming again with power and great glory. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and with thy word and Holy Spirit to bless, and sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may be unto us the body and blood of thy dearly beloved Son, Jesus Christ. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness to accept this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, whereby we often present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls, and bodies. Grant, we beseech thee, that all who partake of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and also that we and all thy whole church may be made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord. By whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, world without end. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. Lamb of God, take us into have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take us into the world. Grant us life. Presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trust in our own righteousness, and on our manifold and great mercies, we are not worthy so much as the bread that becomes on thy table, but thou art the same Lord whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that we may more dwell in him. And he in us. Amen. Together. The gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. we're done.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost feed us in these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and for us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, that we are thy members incorporated in the mystical body of thy Son, the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of the everlasting kingdom. And we humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen. Kindly be seated. Good evening, Jamaica Deanery. Who's missing? Who's missing? No one, right? We have little children, we have grown adults. Everyone is here. You sure? I'm excited. Excited to see all of you. Excited to be in the bestest deanery in diocese. I am ashamed to say. And you see how it began, right? The bestest. Aren't you all proud to be in the best deanery in the diocese?
Yes.
Aren't you all proud to be in the best deanery in the diocese?
Yes.
So if you're proud to be in the best deanery in the diocese, it means we have to rejoice in the Lord always. Always. And again, I say, rejoice. A debt of gratitude to Father Keith. Thank you very much for your words this evening. And to Ken Walker, welcome. This is your first time being at St. Peter's. Welcome. Thank you, my brothers. A debt of gratitude to all who came out last Saturday. To the community at St. Gabriel's for hosting us, to Father Ryan, and to all who came out for the retreat. I hope and pray that you not only had a grand time, but it was reflective as you think of your own journey during this Lenten season, but your journey of faith and your walk with God. I pray that it was life-giving, but more so reflective and inspiring for you to look introspectively at who we are as and who you are as an individual, a beloved child of God. Thank you to Mr. Shimada and the choir, to the acolytes, the Eucharistic ministers. Thank you so very much. The ushers, the St. Luke's health checkers, thank you all for being here, and I'm not letting you go home without anything. There are refreshments downstairs, all right? There are refreshments downstairs. The members of St. Peter's have gone all up to prepare for you, so please stay and share and fellowship. This is the first time that we're doing it this way. Because remember, for the past 2 years, it was always a grab and a go. So you can grab and go, or you can grab and stay. The choice is yours. It's good to see all of you. Welcome to those who are worshiping with us on Zoom or Facebook. It's a joy to have you. And I pray that we'll see each other next Thursday at... You see? You see? Purposely done. Next Wednesday at? Where? St. Gabriel's Hollis for our finale. for this season. But the clergy have put together our Good Friday liturgy. Remember, beginning in 2020, we organized a Good Friday service online. So what we've done again this year is to put together a Good Friday liturgy for the deanery, especially for those who cannot attend any service on Good Friday because of work. We've put together a liturgy for you so that you can not only be fed with the seven last words, but be appreciative of the liturgy that is Good Friday. All right? And that will be aired on Good Friday. Okay? It's good to see all of you. Stay blessed. Stay warm. But more importantly, stay beautiful as a beloved child of God. Bow your heads for God's blessing. Bow down before the Lord. Look down in mercy, Lord, on your people who kneel before you, and grant that those whom you have nourished by your word and sacraments may bring forth fruit worthy of repentance, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our recessional hymn. This is love, not that we love God. He is the sacrifice for our sins. If God loves us so much, if we love one another, let us bless the Lord. Have a blessed night.